Hello children, in the previous class we were studying about the subtraction of 4 digit numbers without regrouping. In this class we will study about the subtraction of the numbers with the regrouping, which means we are taking the borrow from the previous number and we will start subtraction. So subtraction with borrow. Borrowing in the sense that is regrouping. How do we will solve with regrouping means? I will give you an example, one or two examples, then we continue. If the number is 4532, that is 4532, subtracted with 2376. As you can see, first number is smaller than 6. So we have to take the borrow from the previous number. If you take the borrow, it will be a 2. 3 before number is 2 and 1 borrow we will need, so that it becomes 12. 12 minus 6 will be 6, and 2 minus 7 is also not possible. Again, one more time we are taking the borrow. 5 becomes 4 and 2 becomes again 12. 12 minus 7 is 5. 4 minus 3 is 1. 4 minus 2 is 2. So the answer is 2186. Now one more question I will give for you and then the answer for that. 2354 minus 1278. Now find out the answer and tell me. Take the borrow from the previous number. You can pause the video if you want the more time. So I will write the answer. First, the number becomes 4 and the next number is 14. 14 minus 8, you get how much? 14 minus 8 is 6, right? 4 minus 7 is also not possible. So 2 and 14. Again, 14 minus 7 is 7. 2 minus 2 is 0. 2 minus 1. So you should get the answer 1076. Like this we are taking the borrow from the previous number and we are solving. Now we will go with the exercise. I hope you have solved the answers which I have given as homework in the previous class. Now exercise number 2. First main, subtract. The first question is 4816 minus 3507. Find out the answer for this. Take the borrow. Means the first number becomes 16 and previous number becomes 0. First you need to reduce it, then add 1 to that. 16 minus 7 is 9. 0 minus 0 is 0. 8 minus 5 should be passed in writing the answers. 4 minus 3 is 1. So the answer for first one is 1309. Let's see the answer one question. 6883 minus 1562. Here also we need to take the borrow. 5 becomes 4, 3 becomes 13. Now 13 minus 2, it is not correct, right? 3 is a bigger number there. Make the observe. Without seeing the number, if you directly take the borrow, that is also a mistake. Without seeing the number, don't go to the number. Right? What do you do? Anyhow, the first number is a smaller number that you need in the question. You think that first number may be a smaller number, you think, and you start taking the borrow. That is not going to happen. 3 minus 2 is 1. 5 minus 6. If you have the second number, you need to take the borrow. First number is not a borrow. So 5 becomes 15. 8 becomes 7. Now subtract. 3 minus 6 is 9. 7 minus 5 is 2. 6 minus 1 is 5. 5291. Now one more question I will solve for you. And remaining sums, you can do that. Any question or answer you need to say that for a little one more time, you can pause the video so that you get the time to watch that. 6857. Now see the question. First number is smaller only, right? So 5 becomes 15 and 2 becomes 1. 15 minus 7. Now subtract 15 minus 7 is 8. 1 minus 5 is not possible. Again take the borrow. 11 minus 5 can be, that is 6. 8 minus 8 is 0. 9 minus 6 is 3. 3068. Like this, you need to do the subtraction. Still, 5 sums are there. You can solve those sums as a homework. Now, I will directly go to the story sums. That is second question. Now, for the second one, question number I. There are 3050 houses in a town. 1505 houses are painted red. How many houses are not painted? Out of 3050 houses, 1505 are painted red. You need to calculate how many are not painted. So total houses. In town, total number of houses are 3050. And how many are painted red? Means houses that are in red color are 1505. Right? We need to do the subtraction to find out how many houses are. What will be the third sentence or the sentence for the answer? How many houses that are not painted red? We are asking. So, houses that are not painted red, not in red color. Now subtract it. 0 minus 5. Up to 0 minus 5. Take the borrow. 5 becomes 4 and 0 becomes 10. Right? Previous number is 4 and 0 becomes 10. Now 10 minus 5 is 5. 4 minus 0 is 4. Again 0. again 0 minus 5. Again, one more time you take the borrow. 10 minus 5 is 5. 2 minus 1 is 1. So, answer. How many ounces that are not painted red are 1545 houses? Like this, you need to write the word sums. Anyhow, you know that in question only you will be having the sentences. Only you need to rearrange the words and write the sentence. Now I go to the second question. Write the answer to the second question. Jane has 2,655 stamps. Simi has 3,560 stamps. Who has more stamps and how many more? Who has more stamps and how many more? Who is having more stamps? By saying the number you can write it. Who is having more? Yes, Simi has more. That's why we will write the Simi names first. Simi has stamps, or stamps with the Simi you can write. Stamps with the Simi also you can write. That is 3,560 stamps and Jane has stamps, that is 2,655. You should observe here. You need to write the Simi first. You need to write Simi first. Then you need to write Jane. Why? Because Jane is having less. So who is having more? Simi is having more. How many more? You need to calculate now by doing the subtraction. More stamps with the Simi. More stamps with the Simi. How many more? Now subtract. Need to take the borrow. 0 becomes 10. 6 becomes 5. 10 minus 5 is 5. 5 minus 5 is 0. Again 5 minus 6. 5 is smaller number. 5 becomes 15. 3 becomes 15 minus 6. Is 9, right? 2 minus 2 is 0. So how many more stamps does Simi is having? 905. At last you can write, Simi has more number of stamps. How many more she is having? She have, full stop, she have 905 stamps more. She has 905 stamps more. That one you need to mention by because there are who is having more? Simi is having more with 905 stamps. Let this be right at the last. Now the next question is one more for you. I will read out the question and I will explain it once. 3,465 tourists visited the hill station on the New Year's Day. 1,788 tourists went back on 2nd January. 1,788 visited and went back the next day only, that is 2nd January. How many tourists are left in the hill station? How many are left? This sentence is also easy in this. Tourists visited, the New Year's is the first sentence. Tourists left on January 2nd is second sentence. And the last answer will be tourists, those who are still in the hill station. Or tourists in the hill station is the third one. If you subtract first two numbers, you get the answer. Okay, this is for today, and in the next class we'll learn subtraction of the 4-digit number with the zeros. Zeros any of you know, directly we'll go to the exercise and we'll solve. Okay children, this is for today. I hope you have understood the topic and finished the homework that we have left. Thank you, we'll meet in the next class.